Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1680. Create custom theme colors. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Gellin. Last week, episode 1675, I talked about what happened to the office theme colors. Some great questions. Where's the pure green? That was funny. Blue was reserved for blue screens. And then Eileen, hey, I didn't even realize you could go into colors and create my own themes. Do you have a tutorial for that? We'll talk about that today. And then Jim, RGB, blue thing is weird. If you save back to 2003, you get a compatibility warning. All right, so Eileen, let's take a look at how we create our own custom colors. These are the standard office theme in Excel 2013. If you go to page layout, though, there's a colors drop down here where you can change the colors that are used. And they have a whole bunch of different colors that are built in, but you're allowed to create your own. If we go to customize colors, and the way it works, these six accent colors are the ones that are used in charts and in the cell styles accent colors. So we'll go into blue and choose more colors, and let's make this be a pure blue. So 0 red, 0 green, and 255 blue. Click OK. I'll do the same thing here. Let's make this be a pure red. 255 00. Click OK. Pure green. So 0 255 0, and then you can mix colors, obviously. So let's try and create some sort of purple with 255 of red, none of green, and 255 of blue. All right, although I don't really like that, so let's just kind of drag the slider here and try and get to a different purple. Or you can just go to more colors, choose from the standard, there's a lot there, or just try and click around until you find something that looks good. Or if you actually know the actual color, like lots of times web colors are six hexadecimal letters, with the first two being anywhere from 00 up to FF, you need to use hex to dec, DEC, to convert those to regular numbers. But you might have a company color that, for example, is 128, 104, 17, I don't know. And you can match any color that you would like there. While we're here, hyperlinks appearing in blue, we can just change those back to black. And I don't care if I follow the hyperlink or not, change those back to black. And then we'll create a name. So we'll call this the Eileen theme. Click Save. All right, and now that we've created that, it's actually created a file out on our computer, and no matter what workbook I'm in, I create a new workbook here, we'll just create some data, create a chart, click OK, so there's my chart, and if I go to page layout, colors, I can choose Eileen and get those colors that we set up in any workbook on this computer. So it's a great little feature, being able to create custom colors. Now Jim asked about saving back to Excel 2003. You have to go into File, Options, and then under Save, down here, Preserve Visual Appearance of the Workbook, this Colors drop-down gives us the old Excel 2003 color palette, and you would have to come in here and modify to create the exact same colors that you created. They're going to map the colors in this workbook to this palette. So if you created the same six colors here, then it'll be able to map perfectly when you save back to Excel 2003. All right, well, there you have it. Custom theme colors in Excel 2010, Excel 2013. Actually, it still works in Excel 2007 even. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.